Hi, I'm Jason Rossi of Jason's Fantasy Reality on the RemyReport.com. You just gotta click Game Central and then tip down. It says Jason's Fantasy Reality. Just click that. You'll be seeing this. You're already here anyways. And also MyRadio929.com. This is Jason's Fantasy Reality. Start off with the NBA, the big topic right now. Free agency just begun, and Paul Pierce has opted out of his contract for the first time. He more than likely will not be a Celtic heading into the 2010-2011 season. It's going to be crazy because his contract leaving $21.5 million on the table. Where do you get that kind of money? How do you just let that go? I understand with the NBA, it's all about years. It's all about making sure that you're taking care of you and your family. Ridiculous. But nonetheless, Paul Pierce could no longer be a Celtic. He's one of those guys that you realistically thought after the 2008 championship, he won the MVP, that his number was going to go right up there in the rafters. You know, you'd see right up there with 33, 34 would be up there. Not saying that that's necessarily in doubt, but I thought Paul Pierce would be that guy we'd have forever. Hopefully the Celtics can maybe manage re-signing him, doing like a mid-level deal and signing him to like 5 years, backloading the contract, doing a lot of signing bonus, whatever these NBA players need. I don't know, like give him a couple Bentleys or something, whatever they need. But big rumors swirling around. Obviously, this free agency class is ridiculous. You know, you have Dwayne Wade out there, Chris Bosh, LeBron James, of course, which everybody's, you know, going crazy about. Amari Stoudemire, Dirk Nowitzki. There's a lot of players out there. Some of the rumors swirling around about Paul Pierce is that he could be a guy that would team up with a LeBron James and be a mid-level exception to go to maybe the Bulls. He could go to the Knicks if he wanted to, or he could go back home and play for the LA Clippers, because as Paul Pierce, as we know, over the past 2 or 3 years, going to the NBA Finals and playing in LA. If you watch the NBA Finals, Paul Pierce, all he talked about was, oh, you know, this is where I'm from, this is where I want to win, this is where I want to be, this is blah, 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 whatever. It's hot outside, so let's cool off. Let's head into the rink. The Boston Bruins are, you know, still in the headlines out there. Boston Sports, we'll rank them a little later. But, yeah, so you have Tyler Seguin. Am I right, Tyler?
Yeah.
All right, Tyler Seguin and Nathan Horton just Horton?
Yep. Yeah.
Thank you, guys. Just throughout the first pitch at the Red Sox game, they were both introduced wearing their new Boston Bruins uniforms. It's going to be exciting to see. No? Well, they got introduced with their uniforms.
Yes.
Don't say no. But they came out with Red Sox uniforms. I'm talking about they were introduced during the day. Don't call me wrong here, people behind the camera. So they were introduced. They threw out the first pitch. Who do you think had a better pitch?
Tyler.
Tyler, all right, Seguin is the overall behind the scenes. Two of the other people obviously clearly didn't see what happened. But so they came out, they're both introduced. These are going to be mainstays with this team, I'd say, for the next 3 to 4 years, depending on the rookie contract that Seguin is given. Other exciting news with the Bruins is that we re-signed the oldest man in the history to come back on the ice. 72-year-old Mark Recchi will come back for his record. He actually could retire not only just from the NHL, from life. He could just retire and go somewhere, like go down to God's waiting room in Florida, and he could just chill out there with maybe a nice culotta or something. But no, he'll be back on the ice for the Bruins for a record-setting 414th season. So we're really looking forward to that. And some sad news, though. Two things. This whole Mark Savard trade rumors. Oh, as a fan of the team, everybody loves Mark Savard. Interior, I got some inside information. I don't want to name too many names, but, you know, go to the Boston Sports Club and Wall Fan. But up there, there's people that work out there that know the ins and outs of the Bruins. And I've heard that they just don't like Mark Savard within the Bruins organization. They just think he's not hardworking. They think he's lazy. They thought after his injury, after he scored that first goal against the Flyers in that game, in game one, they said that after that, he just didn't try. He was on such a high off that he just didn't care anymore. And that's really upsetting as a fan, because anytime somebody comes off injury, like what happened with Phil Kessel a couple years ago, he had cancer, he came back, everybody loved that guy. But then look what happens. He's not liked behind the scenes, especially in hockey. I feel like this is the most. If you're not loved by your team and your organization, you're out. Lastly, another sad note with the Bruins. My boy, Vladimir Sobotka, was traded to the Blues for the rights of a college player. How is that even legal? Like, the guy's in college. Like, isn't he paying to play? I don't even get it. But, yes, Vladimir Sobotka didn't want to be a fourth-line player anymore, so now he's going to go from the fourth line to the third and a half line for the Blues. Let's move on. The Boston Red Sox are in disarray, but somehow winning games left and right. I couldn't tell you their starting nine right now. It's like looking at the starting nine from 1991. I couldn't tell you. Half the guys on the roster, and they're all bums. if you were to look from like a fantasy perspective or from a you know, baseball card, you know, when you get your baseball cards in the beginning of the year, you're like, oh, Dustin Pedroia, oh, out 6 weeks. Oh, J.D. Drew, oh, he's J.D. Drew. And then you pick up, like, oh, Jacoby Ellsbury, this is my guy. Changes number to number two. I think that's the amount of games he's played this season. And then you get, like, Adrian Beltre. The only, somehow he's the staple, which everybody hated that signing last year, including myself. But he's the guy. So, yes, yeah, so you have Dustin Pedroia out for 6 weeks. Josh Beckett, I don't even remember last time he pitched, maybe spring training or so. You have, who else is injured? Who else we got? Anybody? Anybody remember? Jeremy Hermita, he's out. Jacoby Ellsbury's out. Like, the whole team is injured. Pedroia, yes, and he's out for 6 weeks, and that's with a broken foot without surgery. I don't even know how that's possible, but you break your foot, you're not getting surgery. It wasn't like a toe or something. By the way, try to walk without using your toes. I'll give you 5 seconds to do that later. I want you to try it. But yeah, so you...
Victor Martinez gone.
Victor Martinez, yes, he was just put on the DL. Daisuke Matsuzaka's been on and off. Buchholz isn't going to be on the DL, but he's going to miss a start or two. This team is all over the place, and yet we're two games out, and we're beating Tampa Bay Devil Rays still. Somehow they suck, but I don't get how. But nonetheless, we are really in the middle of a real tough time, but if you're a Red Sox fan, it's really exciting because this is what you want. You know, the Red Sox went from being the lovable losers, then in 2004 winning the championship, have become that team that's, like, really good now. We are to, you know, the nation. Like, the Yankees were always up here, and we were down here. But now we're just at the same, you know, we're right there with the Yankees, payroll-wise and everything. But now with this team, this roster, the Donovan McDonalds of the world, Josh Reddick starting out there, you know, we're really lovable again. You know, even Marco Scudero, I know he's a starter, but he's not a guy that, like, oh, if you're going to need a big free agent, Marco Scudero is your guy. Right, Marco?
That's right.
So, yeah, so we have, you know, a lovable team, and it's good to see this, and they're winning together. And that's what it's all about with baseball. I feel, you know, if that team's together, they can win anything, like we're seeing with the Tampa Bay Rays, not Devil Rays. They're losing because their team is all over the place, yelling at each other. And speaking about the biggest yelling match of the week, Carlos Zambrano. This guy is a bull. He gives up 7 earned runs in an inning. Just goes haywire when he gets into the dugout. Lou Piniella looks like he's wishing he was retired, just like Mark Recchi. And he, you know, just completely goes through the locker room, ripping things up. Go through the dugout, I'm sorry. And then gets in Derek Lee's face. And they start yelling at each other. Zambrano loses it, just starts freaking out on him. And now the Cubs suspend him indefinitely. This guy's like owed 60-something million dollars. Good luck with that, Chicago. That's going to get you a championship. Now let's move on to the sport that really matters in the world, the World Cup. Right, thank you for watching Jason's Fantasy Reality video shoot thing. Come up with a title for that. You can email me at any time right here. It's jasonsfantasyreality@gmail.com. Since you don't want to spell that out because it hurts me to even say it, just click right here and email me your thoughts on this, anything you think about the Celtics, Paul Pierce, Tom Brady, anybody. I need the Vladimir Saboka. I know how upset you are, just like me. Also, Mark Recchi, if he knows how to use an email, he can email me personally. So thank you all for watching. We'll catch you all next week. Da 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 da